Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick, your absolutely, most assuredly favorite brother from another mother. Hope you guys are all doing all right. I've been very busy trying to make some videos tonight. When I get a chance, I'm always busy, brothers and sisters, ministering to our brothers and sisters in the Lord, being a pastor, especially while I'm here in the States, when I'm able to talk to people and stuff a whole lot better than from the Philippines. Just want you brothers and sisters to know I'm praying for you. Anyone that asks me to pray for them, I do pray for them. And I just want to thank all you guys for all the help, for those who have helped with the orphanages and the feeding programs. I'll be packing our stuff up to put in storage now. I'll be flying out from here on Thanksgiving Day, actually flying because the plane tickets are a lot cheaper, flying up to Vancouver and Squamish, British Columbia. I'll be up there for the weekend of the Thanksgiving time weekend here in the United States holiday. Then I'll be heading out to the Philippines before the end of November. Be back in the Philippines until April, brothers and sisters. Still be, you know, people that didn't watch me before, obviously they asked me if I'd still be making videos in the Philippines. Well, of course, those of you who watch me, you know that I've been making videos in the Philippines a whole lot more than the States. Everywhere I go, by the grace of God, if I can get online, I'll make a video. Anyway, brothers and sisters, we'll be heading back to the Philippines, and we'll be having a party there with the orphans and all that, and have a big blowout, with all the orphans and celebrating. And we have new orphans we've been adding. I don't have pictures of some of the new orphans yet. We've been adding new orphans at orphanage number 4. Got to get new house parents at orphanage number 3. I need to do some administrative housekeeping and budget. You know, I need to redo the budget. You know, brothers and sisters, you know, cost of food is always going up, just like in the States, even more than the U.S. Inflation, the pay of you know, the house parents and all that, and then the budgets of the food and all that. I need to increase everything. Ask you guys to help me pray about that, that I know the Lord will provide us. We increase. We're going to be having parties, you know, for the holidays at each orphanage. You know, I'm going to bring them all together at one place, but I also, you know, I don't really have the facilities for all of them at one place, so I may end up having to have a party at orphanage number 2, and 1 and 2 can be combined, and then orphanage number 4, and then number 3, I'll be there. I'll try to be at all of them, but orphanage number 3 is where I'll be staying at, on my base. Anyway, so I need to have Christmas for these kids. You know, the first year we did the orphanages, we had a great big Christmas. People donated for that, and now we got more orphanages, orphans, and more orphanages. And, pushing 30 kids, give or take one or two, we're at 30 kids. And then, of course, we have the 1,000 kids a week that we feed. And I just ask you guys to pray about that because I like to give them toys and stuff. We've been giving them these clothes and stuff. People have been sending clothes through the boxes, through Sister Pearly, school supplies and all that. And then we've been giving them, you know, stuff every year. But I like to get them, you know, some something they can all use. Like if you the first time we got some bicycles. And then they could kind of share them. We didn't have enough for all the kids, but we had like 2 boys and 2 girls' bikes and things like that. I'd like to get more stuff. You know, get the girls some dolls. They want dolls, dollhouses, different things. We did that too. We got a lot of new kids. And so I don't know what it's going to cost, brothers and sisters. You know, I would say it's probably going to be at least $1,000. I mean, not even counting the party. You're talking about gifts for 30 kids? I mean, I don't know how much I want to spend. I want to get them at least one something nice. So it's like 20 or 30 bucks at least, you know, per kid to get something nice. So that's, what is that? Three times three, yeah, $900. So I'm saying basically $1,000 in the parties, you know, and all that. So I ask you guys to pray about that. I know this God will make a way. I got to put the need out there. I guess I probably need $2,000 or $3,000 total for the parties with special food, lots of, you know, nice food for them to have. In the Philippines, they have a midnight meal on New Year's Eve or Christmas Eve, called Noche Buena. They have you know, Christmas and New Year's, and we'd have, you know, parties and special food for them to get all fat and happy and enjoy themselves because, you know, they don't have families. So we want to provide a good time for them. And we always do, but, you know, the Filipino house parents are really good at living without nothing, so they're used to not having any money. So, you know, they won't say anything to me. They'll just get by with what they got, you know, and then by the time I think about it, because they didn't ask me, I'll think about it. Wow, we only had, you know, $100 for the budget at one orphanage for their Christmas meal, and when you got, like, one orphanage has 10 or 12 kids, and, you know, $100 is nothing, you know. We need to have, I want them to have a nice meal, you know. Most of us, especially Americans and Westerners, you know, we've had a nice meal. And, you know, these orphans, how much more? They don't have parents and stuff, you know. So I want to provide nice for them. And I think only the first year we asked for help to do that. And that's been whatever it's been. It was 2012, Christmas 2012. So this is the third year later. And the other years, I don't think I asked. So I'm asking brothers and sisters, if you guys to pray about it. I guess I probably need about 3,000. You know, and I'm always underestimate. You know, because, you know, we're going to have all these expenses. And then transport them around. And if we consolidate some of the stuff and the gifts and the parties and all that, Christmas and New Year time period. And I ask you guys to please pray about that. Those of you who, you know, will pray, they're with the prayer warriors. And then those who donate, God will make a way. I know He really always does. I thank you guys for that. I ask you guys to pray. I need to make another slideshow. It always kills me to make the slideshows when I see those poor street kids that we feed. It's so hard for me, you know, spiritually or emotionally, whatever you want to call it, to make slideshows. All those kids that don't even have shoes and stuff. You know, the need is just astronomical. It's just never ending. You know, it's until the Lord returns. I mean, it's just, you know, it's the poor will be. Jesus said, "You have the poor with you always." You know, as He told us, which is true, until He returns. And so, brothers and sisters, you know, it's just a burden that I don't like to think about, you know, the overwhelming burden. Only the Lord can handle the burden of all the poor people in the world. In the Philippines, you know, it's 100 million people, whatever it is, approximately 100 million people. And, you know, whatever it is, 75% of them are in poverty, you know, and 50% of them, you know, have no electricity, no running water. They take a bath in a river, or, you know, they have the government put some water pumps they can use. They go out there and do their laundry, take a bath with, you know, wearing partially clothed to take their bath, do their laundry in public. And, you know, they cook with scrap wood they find that falls from coconut trees. Half the Filipinos in the whole country. So anyway, brothers and sisters, you know, we're, of course, I want to say this to those for people that haven't seen my videos. Of course, we're evangelizing them. The Lord gave us this ministry for Joshua's ministry. Little child would lead them and suffer little children to come unto me and forbid them not, for such is the kingdom of heaven. So the purpose of Joshua's ministry is to feed them and clothe them and do the orphanages and the feeding programs to the poor kids. But of course, we're teaching them like vacation Bible school. We have church every Sunday at the orphanages. And then when we do the feedings on weekends all over the place, we've got like 12 or 14 different places, we do feedings spread out over a 3-hour apart area, 3 or 4 hours spread out, you know, between from one location to the next. And the local pastors are doing it, and they're reading them. People have donated through the boxes we've sent, you know, little children's books and shoes. And then we feed them, and then we tell them the gospel. And it's like we do like vacation Bible school and all that every weekend. We do like a little one-day deal. Like they have vacation Bible school or children's church every weekend. And then they get fed too. So I ask you guys to pray about all that. I thank the Lord. I haven't really ever had to ask for funds. And I know God will provide, but I just want to get this out there before I leave out to the Philippines. So it'll be in you guys' mind to pray about it. God bless all you guys, and I'll be back shortly with a video by the grace of God here in the next few hours.